Yeah, I was born in South Africa, Cape Town, South Africa, and then I moved to England when I was about 7 or 8, I think. And then I moved back down, moved down to Southampton when I was 13, 14, about there. And that's when I found the gym. I think it was like year 9 or 10, we had like work experience, and I didn't have anything, and then the last couple of days I had to find something, I went into the gym because it was near my house. I spoke to Dean, and he said, yeah, that's fine, you can come in, lock up the gym for like, open up and lock up, clean up for 2 weeks, and then train while you're doing it. And then I snapped it up, done that. Really enjoyed the training because I was doing cricket at the time, so I'd done it for fitness for that. And then about 9 months later, I had a fight and just fell in love with it. Yeah, I had a rough time, like I fell out with my parents, and I was like, some kids just go off out of their house doing their own thing. I was living a bit rough, and then Dean always helped me out as like a coach and like a mentor, like a father figure. He always helped me out, and he said, oh, you've got nowhere to stay, you might as well stay in the gym and help out in the gym, and it'll help you out like that. There's a spare room. So I just moved into the gym, started doing PTs more in the gym. I was helping out with classes and that, and I ended up staying there for like 2 years, and it was really good because I was spending so much time in the gym. I was really, I had time to learn loads of different things like MMA, Jiu-Jitsu, or just exploring with different things to learn, and it helped my love for the sport grow. And then yeah, it was a good time while I was here, and then obviously I had to move out and explore my life in other ways to carry on in my career. Probably like people would say, probably the biggest one so far would be knocking out Manachai Tai, because for me anyway, because going into that fight I had a lot of people come to watch because it was in Southampton, but everyone coming to watch was almost coming to support me in a loss. Everyone was there to support me losing and be there to be like, oh, well done, you fought Manachai, well done, you fought a legend. And even like my dad, my corner, some of them was like, just before the fight, they was like, oh, it's 5 rounds, it's gonna be hard, just get through it, like, it's right. And I'm thinking, fuck me, man, I'm about to fight, what are you about, just get through it.
Representing
Abdurrahman come out very strong at the beginning of each round.
Oh, massive shot there! Danny, he has dropped Manachai with that punch combination. I don't believe what I'm seeing, and nor the crowd. Manachai is out.
And it was sort of just me and Dean who really believed that I was gonna win. I knew I was gonna win. Dean said, if you stick to the game plan, you'll knock him out in 3 rounds. If you stick to the game plan, you'll knock him out. And he said it just before the fight to a few people outside, and then we went in. And when we done it, it was sort of like, it was just me and Dean, we was like, yeah, we done it. That was it, it was amazing. Yeah, when I fought Craig, that fight, yeah, we knew Craig was going to be, we knew he was dangerous.
Walking totally down, elbows are beautiful, and he gets ground and gets
I didn't stick to the game plan that fight, I didn't. Do what I should have done, so I made it hard, a lot harder than it should have been. And all credit to Craig, he's a great fighter, I like his style. But yeah, at that moment, I just sort of, he went for something mad at the spin with a back fist or something, and I just read it and managed to catch him, so yeah, it's a good moment.
And the Reds gonna mow Abdurrahman! And your appreciation, please, for Craig.
I think it's good being number one, and I want to cement my place there with this fight against the French fella. I know he's from a top level gym, and he's a good technical, good base. I saw a couple of fights from Dean, mentioned it the other day. I had a few watch, so yeah, I want to cement my place against him, and then if there's any challenges for the number one spot, I'd be happy to defend it, because obviously I want to fight the best and be the best and prove why I'm the best. So, yeah.